Hello everyone, this is Mike Estras Nagales. Let's discuss the evolution of man.
Evolution of man is the evolutionary process within the history of primates that led to the emergence of Homo sapiens as a distinct species of the hominid family, which includes the great apes. The 11 evolution of man. Number 1, Ramapithecus. Number 2, Australopithecus. Number 3, Pithecanthropus. Number 4, Proplyopithecus. Number 5, Heidelbergsman. Number 6, Neanderthalman. Number 7, Cro-Magnon man. Number 8, Homo habilis. Number 9, Homo erectus. Number 10, Dryopithecus. The last, Egyptopithecus. Ramapithecus is a former name for an extinct group of primates that lived from about 12 to 14 million years ago, for a time regarded as a possible ancestor of Australopithecus and therefore of modern humans. Australopithecus, the fossil assumed to be the intermediate between man and ape, was discovered in Pleistocene cave deposit of South Africa in 1924 by Dark. Australopithecus have been divided into four species based on the dentith law and the brain size. They are Australopithecus afarensis, Australopithecus africanus, Australopithecus robustus, and the last is Australopithecus boisei. Pithecanthropus remains of the most famous of all fossils, so-called Java or ape man. Pithecanthropus erectus were discovered near Trinal, Java by the Dutch physician Eugene de Vries in 1891. The fossil selections includes a skull cap, a thigh bone, and two molar teeth. Cranial capacity was 900 to 1,000. The uranium was low, especially in the frontal regions, and the bony brow above the eyes were comparatively heavy. Proplyopithecus is an extinct genus of primates. The 40-centimeter-long creature assembled today's gibbons. Its eyes face forwards, giving it stereoscopical vision. Proplyopithecus was most likely an omnivore. It is possible that Proplyopithecus is the same creature as Egyptopithecus. Heidelbergsman or Homo heidelbergensis is an extinct species or subspecies of Arctic human which existed during the Middle Pleistocene. It was subsumed as a subspecies of H. erectus in 1950 as H. E. heidelbergensis, but towards the end of the century it was more widely classified as its own species. Neanderthal man are an extinct species or subspecies of archaic humans who live in Eurasia until about 40,000 years ago. They most likely went extinct due to assimilation into the modern human's genome, great climatic change, disease, or a combination of these factors. Cro-Magnon man, population of early Homo sapiens dating from the Upper Paleolithic period. 40,000 to 10,000 years ago in Europe, Neanderthalensis to be representative of prehistoric humans. Modern studies suggest that Cro-Magnon emerged even earlier, perhaps as early as 45,000 years ago. Homo habilis is an extinct species of archaic humans from the early Pleistocene of east of South Africa, about 2 to 3 and 1.65 billion years ago. Homo erectus is an extinct species of archaic humans from the Pleistocene, with its earlier occurrence about 2 million years ago, and its specimens are among the first recognizable members of the genus Homo. Dryopithecus is a genus of extinct great apes from the middle-late Miocene boundary of Europe, 12.5 to 11.1 million years ago. The last, Egyptopithecus. Egyptopithecus is an early fossil catarrhine that predates the divergence between hominoids and cercopithecines. It is now from a single species, Egyptopithecus coeus, which lived around 38 to 29.5 million years ago in the early part of the Oligocene epoch. That's all. Thank you.